Welcome to this advanced JavaScript game development tutorial, where you will learn how to build a clone of your mom's favorite game, Candy Crush. Replit is sponsoring this course, and they make it quick and easy to start up a project. So I'll just create a new HTML, CSS, and JavaScript project. And since I'm teaching JavaScript, I'll just paste in the minimal HTML and CSS. Now in the JavaScript file, I'll get references to the HTML components I'll be working with and create a squares array that I will eventually fill with the candy. I'll create a helper function that will return a random piece of candy. Now I'll create a loop to add all the initial pieces of candy to the game. I'll make sure the squares of candy are draggable, and they each have an ID to reference later. I'll fill each with a random piece of candy, and then add to the grid and squares arrays. Let's test to see what it looks like so far. This looks pretty good. Our version of the game just uses a 3x3 grid. Now let's add the game logic. First I'll create the variables that will be used. Then I'll add event listeners to each square of candy. The drag start and drop events are the important ones, but we need to make sure nothing happens on drag over. The drag start function will just store which candy square was chosen. The drag drop function will do the heavy lifting. First, I'll switch the candy between the drag start square and the drag drop square. Now I'll check to see if there's a match of three candies. In our version, we're only looking for matches on columns, not rows. If all three candies in a column match, I'll add one to the score and use a loop to replace all the candies in the column. Time to test out the game. This is pretty fun. It's almost as good as the real game. You can now put advanced JavaScript game developer on your resume. Thanks for watching.